Stop hoping for your business to grow and start mastering the formula for success that every entrepreneur needs to grow their business. Join us for 5 Plus 1 Mastery, where every week we go in depth on how to grow your business the right way. Learn more at 5plus1mastery.com.
You explained it perfectly. You have the humble man inside, you know, but you have that alpha on the outside. And that alpha on the outside, look, people want a leader that doesn't have to turn around to see if they're being followed, right? Mm-hmm. They're leading the way. And leaders create, they don't compete, right? So they're creating the path forward. They're not competing with someone else, oh, he's better than me, that kind of stuff. That's the alpha catch that everyone gets into.
I'm your host, Chaz Wilson. I bring you successful entrepreneurs, add valuable wisdom to your journey, and help you succeed. Welcome to Connect, Share, and Prosper.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Connect, Share, Prosper. I'm your host, Chaz Wilson. I am joined today with two amazing gentlemen I'm going to introduce to you in a second. We're excited you're with us for this. This is going to be a great episode. We have a lot of things to discuss and very timely discussion. You may recognize one of the gentlemen, Stephen Kuhn, who's with us today. He's been on a previous episode, and I'm excited to have him back. Let me introduce him, and then I'll introduce our additional guest as well here. Stephen is a military combat veteran. Stephen put his experience to work after leaving the military and completing his MBA at Bradford University School of Business Management. He's done that by leading teams and turning around multi-million dollar businesses for 20 plus years in 9 countries to the tune of 500 million plus in revenue. So we want to welcome Stephen to the episode of Connect, Share, Prosper. And then also Lane Belone. Lane grew up in Oklahoma and served in the military for 12 years from 2005 to 2017, most of which as a Green Beret. During his service, he deployed to Iraq twice, Northern and Central Africa, and worked in and traveled all over Europe. Lane is an expert in skill acquisition and high performance and has been entrusted to operate around the globe in high-risk and sensitive missions. Please help me welcome both Stephen and Lane to Connect, Share, Prosper. Welcome, guys.
Thank you, Chad.
Glad to be here.
So I'm curious, here you have two very equipped, very talented men. How did you guys come together and meet, and where did that happen?
Lane?
Yeah, so Steve and I are both veterans. And
by the way, thank you for your service, both of you.
Thank you for that. Appreciate it. So yeah, Stephen and I were part of a group called the Vetpreneur Tribe a number of years ago. And Stephen had written a post about this masculine awakening ceremony of all things that really grabbed my attention. And a lot of things happened after that, but it was a very synchronistic way for Stephen and I to really connect with each other. And Stephen and I met actually in Peru for the first time. And it was a really powerful experience. And it's something that we actually take veterans and entrepreneurs down every single year down to Peru. And yeah, but it was just an interesting way for two seemingly different kinds of people, different backgrounds. Because a lot of people ask, like, Stephen, Lane, like, you guys are kind of different kind of fellas. And but we just hit it off. I you know, I believe, and I think Stephen believes that, you know, us meeting was destiny, that we have a greater mission for us to accomplish together. And it's just a really powerful way to synchronistically meet.
When we met in Peru, it was with plant medicine. So we were working with two different kinds of plant medicine, sacred plant medicine, the feminine and the sacred feminine and the masculine. And it just, you know, for some people that might be a little woo-woo. But what it does is it streamlines and collapses time and letting go of blockages and finding your true purpose and your identity. Which then, of course, led to a lot of other things that we've done together. We've done in-person events, sold out in 45 minutes. We have online masterminds. We have online paid groups, mostly with veterans, but also with civilians. Our book just came out, Unleash Your Humble Alpha, based on our lives and how we live. There's no theory in that book at all. It's all about how we live our lives. There's a story in every chapter, a lesson from that story. And then, of course, the action steps to the T, exactly what you need to do to own your presence in life and become the epic leader you've always wanted to be.
Yeah, let's talk about that. So the book, Unleash Your Humble Alpha. By the way, I love that. And before we go too far, you guys can get it. We'll put the link in here where you can get this book on Amazon. Love it. You both have. I should have a copy. I need to get my copy. I'll get it out there. So Unleash Your Humble Alpha. I want to make a reference to a point you guys just said of how you met, et cetera. And then I want to jump to the book because I think it's timely right now. Amongst so many things happening, in our country, but in across the world that are that's happening. You said, here's two gentlemen that maybe from the outside seeming different, whatever it is, but came together. And I think that right now is something that's being missed. Everybody's focusing on differences. And yet there's so much common ground when people just take a minute, slow down, take some time, get to know the person that's sitting there that they can have this. And you guys had that sort of special experience that then created this bond where the two of you could come together, even with seemingly differences.
Well, we had, it's funny you say that because Lane and I have a very clear principle, and that is see the potential in everyone. So when you look at someone, no matter what's happening, if it's negative or positive, whatever, that's not the point. What's the point? What's the potential in your kid? What's the potential when they mess up? What's the actual potential instead of what they did wrong? You do this with people around you. You do it with business partners, with friends and family, and that creates an entirely different view of the world. So if you're always looking for what can be and not what you're not supposed to do, everything changes. It also has to do with that vocabulary and the language you speak yourself with. You speak to yourself with, like, oh, I can't do this, I can do that, or no, actually, I can do this or I can do that. A big difference. Yes. It's self-programming. I mean, Lane can probably explain it better. That's sort of his area.
Yeah, well, the whole book is decoding how to intuitively own your presence. And there's some people that naturally own presence in life. And there's some people that learn it through processes, through frameworks. And so for those that don't have that presence that they feel that they know that they deserve and they could express out into the world, this book is the decoded step-by-step action steps for them to implement in their lives in order for them to just walk into the world truly who they are, truly themselves, and have that invisible presence. Because we know those people that walk into the room and then all of a sudden, like, boom, the energy shifts. Everyone kind of like looks over to there and they're like, who is this guy? Yeah. Like, they don't have to say anything. But it's their presence that radiates. And it's not this cockiness. It's this confidence. It's this humble alpha power within themselves that is just radiating something. Everybody's feeling it. And they're like, hey, I want to go talk to that person.
Yeah.
So let's dive into the book just a little bit. And let me maybe just for a second be the interviewer. And I'll take my own hat off here just for a second of my own thoughts, because there may be somebody listening to this. The title, Unleash Your Humble Alpha. First of all, I want you to tell us what this book is about, but let's start there and I'm going to dive into some deeper questions, but tell me, just give me the 30-second overview of what the book is about. And then I want to dive into a little bit deeper here.
Okay. So, it's shorter than 30 seconds. So basically it's about finding your true identity, not a title or a position, not what you do, but who you really are. That leads to uncovering your purpose. And that leads to amplifying your identity through your purpose, creating that magic that we call certainty. And certainty, when you have that, it allows you to let go of the how you're going to do something. It's about the intention. We focus on the only thing you can control, and that's the intention. You can't control the outcome.
Okay, so who's the book for? Just anyone in business, anyone in general? Just who's the book for?
It's funny you say that, because we wrote it for men because, surprise, we're men. And and we wanted to start there. And of course, this is a great lesson on niche, because what's going to happen is, what you're going to hear what happened is, we niched for men. And then suddenly over 50% of our buyers and interested parties were women. And so we're like, huh, okay, yeah. So we would have never known that if we just said it's for everybody. But the core principles, the message, the steps and standards that we go through in there, like HIT, honesty, integrity, transparency, or life enterprise, or creating space, or investing in relational capital and quality of life, are the five areas we talk about. That's applicable to everyone in the world. And that's the cool thing about this book, is that actually women are buying this book now, parents, mothers, to raise their children this way. And so that's going to be one of our next books, is Unleash Your Humble Alpha Parent.
I love that. By the way, you kind of went where I was going, but I was curious, when you read, when I heard the title of your book, Unleash Your Humble Alpha, it feels like right now, and I had another guest on, which is why I was on this topic, when they brought up this idea of, there's some certain words right now that feel like you can't say, that kind of came up, and like talking about masculinity and alpha is like somehow pulling down somebody else. And that's not necessarily what you're saying, but tell me about the title, how you came up with this title, Unleash Your Humble Alpha.
Yeah. So we had this, experience in Peru, and it's where we realized insights, epiphanies, and that allows us to crystallize the vision as we move forward. And at the time, Stephen had a group called The Humble Man, And I had a group called the Authentic Alpha. And then all of a sudden, boom, we just like humble alpha. That's it. Because it mixes the two of our kind of experiences in life and melds it into a more profound and more well-rounded philosophy in moving forward, not only in leadership, but in living in life in general. And so we realized the name in Peru, and we actually didn't use that name, Humble Alpha, for a number of months because we were just like, oh, that's perfect. And then we were just waiting for the right moment for it to be used in the best way possible. And that's the actual trusting yourself, trusting your intuition, and allowing yourself to let go of the how, in which we talk about in the book, having that crystal clear vision on where we're moving, but then also letting go of how we get there.
Mm. I love that. So you don't see the word humble and alpha as sort of contradictory. You see them as complementary.
Completely.
And more complete picture.
Yeah, it's actually the true, I mean, a true alpha, if they're only alpha, they're not balanced. You know, they're that integration part fails because alpha is known as the outside, right? So that's the outside force, and the humble's on the inside force. So you have the alpha presence, but you have the humble in the inside source of humility. And that humility is the most powerful force that you can have. It's humility in war, humility in battles, humility in any kind of argument, in any kind of discussion will always win.
You know what I love? I'm soaking in this place where you guys are talking about, because what I love about the title, just, and I'm sorry if I'm kind of like beating the dead horse of the title. I love the title. But the humble alpha, the thing that I find is fascinating is I'm sort of intuitively thinking about people, leaders that I know. There, it has to be both, because if you're an alpha only, and I know I'm reiterating what you guys already know because you wrote about it, but if you're an alpha only, you could be seen as this dominant force that's more like a dictator that, you know, is just overpowering. And then there are these people I see that are humble leaders, but almost too humble, where they sort of don't lead. They just sort of like, oh, well, I'm going to stand back. No, like they want you to lead and you need to kind of step into it a little bit more. So I'm loving this phrase. I may even start to promote it more of what you guys are teaching, this humble alpha.
Well, it's funny you say that because, you know, we work with coaches, consultants, all kinds of people, and there's already people calling us telling them they're using the book verbatim to coach their corporate clients. They're using the book verbatim to coach their other clients and teaching other coaches from our book directly. And that's because what you said, you explained it perfectly. You have the humble man inside, you know, but you have that alpha on the outside. And that alpha on the outside, look, people want a leader that doesn't have to turn around to see if they're being followed, right? Mm-hmm. They're leading the way. And leaders create, they don't compete. Right? So they're creating the path forward. They're not competing with someone else. Oh, he's better than me. That kind of stuff. That's the alpha catch that everyone gets into. I got to be stronger than the next. Oh, that guy's going to get CEO. I got to be CEO. That kind of thing. That all falls away because there's no power in that. And that's a total title, a position. I'm gaining my power from the outside. It's temporary. You're going to run out of gas sometime. When that title changes, what happens to your personality? What happens to you? What happens to your identity? How do you feel when suddenly you lose your job and you're not the CEO anymore and you got to go be a golf caddy? What happens to you? Well, I can tell you what happens to me is when I was a corporate executive, 3,500 employees, 9 countries, 87 locations. I lost that job. I was a doorman a month later, a doorman in a club. And I had the same presence. I had the same enthusiasm and I had the same connection to everyone who walked into that door. And you know what happened? Within 3 months, I was back on my feet again because someone at that door saw me and said, holy shit, who's this guy?
Yeah.
So you have nothing to do with my ability. It's on the inside. It's that power, the presence that radiates. We call it your nuclear reactor right here.
Yeah.
And it's just power. It's that small, but it's bam. It gives you that presence. Walk into a room. Don't say a word. Don't say a word. And bam, it happens.
And it's sort of like an internal identity, right? Like this eternal internal identity that you have of who you are.
It's that knowingness inside within you that's invisible. And it's your experience, it's everything, that how you interact in the world, and from that invisibleness then you can outwardly express it. And that's where the humble, or that's where the alpha comes in. That's the outward expression. And to be able to use that, you know, being able to be a leader in front of people, being able to take massive action when you need to. But you know those leaders that always tell about their accolades and do you know who I am? They don't have that thing within them that's that knowingness, because they're trying to compensate by outward expression. And so what we're doing is we're working from the inside out.
Right. And it's funny. He says, do you know, you've heard someone say, you know who I am, right? And you're like, no, but right. I'm sure you're going to tell me. And they say, well, I'm the CEO. I said, actually, excuse me. That's what you do. That's not who you are. Who are you really? And they're like, what do you mean?
Yeah. I'm fascinated by this not only, but because I've had a lot of guests recently on the show. I'm giving you guys a ton of kudos on this because they've sort of described peripherally what you're talking about, but haven't been able to identify exactly what you're talking about, which is why this book is so timely and will be timeless because it's true with the things that you're teaching. And so what I love about it is, you know, there are these leaders right now that are struggling, and I see it. And we've had lots of discussions with guests who they struggle with this, like, if I'm just the alpha, I could be seen too dominant. And people may be put off by that. But so I try to be more humble, but then I'm not getting anywhere. And
That whole thought process is on the outside. And remember, thoughts aren't real. You know, thoughts lead us down paths that don't even exist yet. So it's all on the outside. We're looking for a structure. We're looking for a plan. We're looking for a shortcut. We're looking for a funnel, something to get us to where we want to go. It's right here. It's all right here. You got to let go of all that stuff. Let go of all of it and find out who your true identity is. In the book, we go literally step by step. This is how you find your identity. Do this. Ask yourself this. What's your favorite that? You know, we really break it down. There's a guy that he was actually a lieutenant colonel in the military, retired after 30 years, read our book. It took him 2 weeks to get through the first chapter just to get through those questions to figure out who he really was. And wow. Most people won't put that work in. But this guy knew after 30 years in the military, that's the only identity he ever knew. So he had to find his true identity. And this guy is exploding.
So so good. So, you know, it's interesting in our world of networking and the things that people, they go to these networking events and it's interesting because so many times you introduce, oh, hi, I'm Steven, I'm Chaz, what do you do? Like, that's the first thing people ask, well, what do you do? It's like, no, the deeper question is, who are you?
Yeah.
Right? Who are 100%. You? And so what you're saying is people so often attach this identity to what they do, which isn't necessarily who they are.
And the cool thing about that is if you reverse engineer it, you figure out who you are, how you interact in the world, and what your purpose is, it's that much easier to use your title, your position, as an amplifier of that true purpose that you have in life, and to be able to radiate that out. And instead of it, just you as a person figuring out what your purpose is and doing that, it's you using your business projects as a vehicle to amplify it 10x, 100x, more than you could do just by yourself.
Oh, so good. So I'm listening to this podcast. Something's kind of stirred me and I want to go get this book. Obviously I can go get it, but I had somebody on last week who talked about real estate investing. Okay. Well, if I have this sort of like internal trigger that I want to invest in real estate, well, gosh, I know I need to read this book. What's sort of something that somebody listening to this goes, oh, that's what I'm thinking. Now I need to go read this book. Like, who's this book for? I know we kind of answered that, but if I'm listening to this, I go, oh, I had that thought. I definitely need to read this book. Like, what are those sort of triggers that they need to go get this book? If this happens, or if I'm experiencing this, I should go get this book. I don't know if that made sense, but I'm trying to get it out that way.
I'm still trying to.
So try to answer clarity. That confusing question.
People who seek clarity, because clarity is key. Because whenever you are clear about who you are, you're clear about what you're doing, you're clear about where you're going, then it makes that much easier and you can let go of the how. And so if you're seeking clarity, if you're seeking who am I, what am I supposed to do, what are the steps I need to take, that's the person that's going to read this book and get a lot out of it.
Yeah, and we take them through those steps too. For instance, HIT, I think we talked about it in the last episode, honesty, yes. Integrity, transparency, honesty with yourself while you do what you do, and transparency is how you step into the world. Without honesty, it's your ongoing reputation, and of course, integrity is the byproduct. That's the hardest part because, you know, being honest with yourself, like, why do you do what you do? Why do you say what you say? Why do you act and react the way that you do? When you break that down, it is so powerful. And that's like the foundation of everything we do. We have is like a core, the core principles of HIT. And then we build upon that with the creating space, with the life enterprise, with the investing in relational capital. And of course, quality of life, which is our name of our company, by the way, QOL Enterprises.
Really? I did not realize that. Quality of life. Yeah. So what's the outcome you want for somebody who says, you know, when you sit down and write a book, I'm writing my third book right now. And I think that was one of the, like, I had this idea. I'm like, I want to write this book. And then someone asked, okay, so the reader, what's the outcome that you want them to have? And I was like, wait, I didn't think about that. You know, it's like, I had this great idea, and now I got to like articulate the result we want. But what's the result someone gets? I'm talking more for you guys. Like, this is more your dream of what you wanted from the book.
Oh, okay. Because it's actually what they're going to get is right there. So it's like own your presence in life and become the epic leader that you're meant to be. You know, I think this is, you know, we believe this is the true beginning of a movement that leadership. I mean, we wanted to do a book before the election, you know, the humble alpha citizen. Like, how do we become humble? How can we empower those above us if we're not empowered? How can we trust those above us if we don't trust ourselves? And so that's the vision that we see, is that this is a movement of people that are going to realize that, you know what, all that stuff on the outside, all that distraction, those thoughts that lead us down paths of terror and fear, we don't need any of that. Thoughts aren't real. We react to our thoughts about a situation and not about the situation. You know, it's incredible.
Yeah, people latch on to external stories that other people tell them about themselves. So as a young kid, you listen to your parents, you listen to teachers, you listen to advisors, you listen to people on TV, other influencers that have no idea who you are. And they tell us a story of who we're supposed to be. And we listen to that story. And so now the you know, part of the book and the movement of the Humble Alpha is to help other people to realize that they can write their own story of their life. They can have horrible experiences, they can have tough upbringings, they can have challenges that they overcome, but what about now? What story do they want to tell with their life now? And to be able to realize that power that they have that's within themselves already, it's already there, that now they have a formula, now they have a framework, now they have action steps, because it's all laid out in the book.
And I want to take this away from the esoteric a little bit, because a lot of people might be thinking, oh, this is very esoteric and stuff. This is what made me gave me the power to do what I did in my life and what Lane did in his life. I mean, I couldn't have just walked up to Mick Jagger and became his bodyguard without this power inside of me, or worked for Andrea Bocelli. Lane climbed Mount Vesuvius,
Kilimanjaro,
among others. Among others. And these are things we decided and we did it. Right. So the practical side is this, you know, right now, you know, I've acquired 4 companies in the last 9 months, and I'm acquiring a company right now for almost $20 million from a guy who doesn't know anything about M&A, who just started learning it. It's pretty amazing. Why am I able to do that? Why is Lane running a documentary series for a company in America where we're interviewing veterans all the way across America? Why is this happening? Because we trust ourselves and we know who we are, and we tackle anything because anything is possible. There's always a solution. There's always a solution out there. And we get stuck in our heads. You know, society gets stuck in their heads. Oh my God, no one's ever done this before. How's it supposed to work? And da, da, da. What are you talking about? Create. Remember, leaders create, they don't compete.
Man, so many, you just almost opened up the box for like 3 more episodes, but that's a separate thing. But that's what you do. I love having you guys on this episode. I think, again, as I said before, this is such a timely message right now. And people need to hear this, because what you just said about trusting yourself, I think there's so much fear that people buy into right now, like the what ifs. And statistically, what if probably won't even happen. You know, I was watching election results just sitting there last night, and because I get fascinated with some of the data. Like, I'm kind of a data guy, and I like watch data. And I'm watching they literally spent an hour of what ifs.
Yeah.
That literally, I don't think any of those what ifs are playing out, but it's to build the time, you know, spend the time. Yeah. And I think we do that in life. It's like our brain goes into all these what ifs, almost like this defense mechanism.
That's the thought again. You know, I mean, when, once you realize that a thought is literally you talking yourself into a new direction or a different direction that doesn't even exist yet, you just say, stop thinking it, or direct it to something positive that you want to happen, not what you don't want to happen. You know, it's like Lane said the other day, like, you don't tell your kids, like, if you want to be positive, you tell your kids, hey, stop running. You say, hey, please walk safely. You know, it's like, that's the different dialogues that we got to have with each other. That's where that comes in, where if you're talking to yourself, that self-dialogue we spoke about, that's so important. We're our biggest motivators. We're our biggest inspirers. We are ourselves. Yeah. When you feel that power, that you can do, and you know that you can do anything on this plane, anything. It's just, you're unstoppable. Sometimes you got to be careful what you do with it. I mean, look, Lane is 33, right? I'm 53. That's a big difference. We're 2 generations, but we're one, man. We're one because we follow the same core principles. We have the same beliefs. We see the same vision in front of us. 2 different guys from different worlds. You know, I mean, this is all because it can only happen because we are our own people. I don't look over his shoulder to see what he's doing. He doesn't look over my shoulder to see what I'm doing. We have 100% trust between each other, and he does what he has to do, and I do what I have to do, sometimes together, sometimes separate. But we always end up with the same mission going forward. That's amazing. That's amazing. But you know what? It was effortless. It was effortless.
Well, yeah. I think that, I mean, what you just said, it could be just transposed into companies and governments and leaders and all this stuff.
There's a whole chapter. There's a whole chapter in the book about how you do this in your company. So how do you, once you get your identity, purpose, and certainty, how do you take that to your team, creating through a mission and a vision? How do you take that to your team? How do you get them to align, like Lane said, align your purpose with the company and then have them align their purpose with their company once they find their identity? I mean, that's the powerful thing about it. So it's a humble alpha you, a humble alpha team. And when you have a humble alpha team, less conflict, less argument, more productivity, more creativity, you know, it's just streamlined.
So yeah, good. Compliments are so much easier to find whenever you know exactly who you are, how you interact in the world, what you're all about, what you like. And so whenever you clearly define that for yourself, it's just like a partner. When you clearly define that for yourself, it's much easier for you to find that compliment and say, oh, you like that, I like that. And then just like, boom, you know, and you can create a whole architecture. You can create your teams around that to where skill sets are complementary, to where you're not overlapping. You know, you don't have five visionaries in the company. You have a visionary, you have an operations guy, you have a guy that, so you have all these different complementary aspects. And so once you have that clarity, you're able to then piece it all together in a very harmonistic way that's going to accomplish the mission or the vision of the company.
And so good. So many things, powerful. Let me, again, guys, unleash your humble alpha, go on Amazon. We'll put the link, get a copy. In fact, don't just get a copy, buy an extra copy, give it to somebody you think definitely could benefit from this book. I think that's the greatest gift you could do with this powerful book. We'll put the link in the show notes. Just to kind of put this together, you know, we have, I think this is good timing when you talk about identity and certainty, because Stephen, you referenced this, and I'm sure Lane, you have stories of this too, where like, Stephen, you had to like reinvent a little bit, like you go from this getting laid off to this doorman to like this sort of reinvent, but yet your identity was solid where you were. There are people within our network who listen to the show and et cetera, where say COVID or other things like this have really deeply impacted. Now they're where they're at is they're in this phase of like a reinvention of career or whatever. What advice would you give somebody right now who's listening to the show who said either their business is down, they lost their business, whatever it might be, and they're in that kind of space? Number one, get the book. I get that. But number two, what other advice would you? That way you didn't have to shamelessly plug.
Right. No one knows you like you do, right? But like you could, put it that way. So find yourself first. And you're right. It's read the book. I can't give any other advice, number one. Number two is if you want to get somewhere and you don't know how to get there, ask somebody who's already been there and done that. It's that simple, for real. I mean, I ask people every single day for assistance, ideas, thoughts. I mean, that's one of my mojos of life is asking questions. People want to go it alone. They want to prove it to themselves. Always, it doesn't mean anything. You want to get somewhere? Ask somebody who's been there. Collapse that time, make it happen. I'm sure Lane has something more eloquent.
Good. No, just add too, like questions are incredibly powerful, and the better questions that we can ask ourselves, the better answers, because the information's out there, the people are out there, the knowledge is out there. I mean, the internet's a prime example. It's a matter of what questions are we asking ourselves and for our business to get the results that we want. And so by us asking better questions, by us having a clear vision of where we're going, it makes that pathway or that journey for you to get there, collapse time, remove steps, and to be able to enjoy the ride that much more, because you're not worried about how am I going to do it? All the worries. I'm not overthinking everything. I'm not what-ifing everything, because I'm getting that clarity of focus. And so it's such a powerful way to move forward in the world.
Isn't it a fascinating cycle of life that we have something in front of us and we don't, our first instinct isn't to think somebody probably already did this. Somebody's probably already, and it's like not the instinct for most of us to go.
Well, yeah, it's, you know, I do a video every day. I think I'm on episode 550 or 520 or whatever it is. And I must say that 4 out of 5 days a week, you know, ask the damn question. Today it was like solutions. Just freaking ask, solve the problem, ask who can solve it, make it happen, move forward, collapse time. You know, And that's the drive that I have on the inside, because I know there's a solution for everything. If I don't know it, it's like when you're in a business meeting, someone says, how can you buy a $20 million company? You have no idea how to do the structuring of the business and stuff. I said, I know people who do.
That's right.
Simple that's as
right.
that.
I don't need to know it, right?
Exactly. Exactly. So people go in a meeting and they're like nervous. Oh my God, what if they ask me a question that I can't answer? And I'm like, you know what, John, that's a great question. Let me get back to you with an accurate answer from my team. Done.
Yeah, right.
Simple. Yeah, and you don't have to know everything.
And here we overcomplicate it all. Yeah. And we like, you know, that's by the way, that's why they're not buying the $20 million company, because they're asking you how can you do it?
Exactly. Well, I just
did it.
Nailed it. Right. You nailed it, brother.
That's why they're not doing it. So yeah, I mean, it's fascinating. You said that I was in a leadership retreat with my team. We did a summer retreat at a cabin, and we were kind of all sitting in this room, and it just dawned on me. And I went around the room and I went to my COO and I said, hey, prior to you being the COO to this company, when were you ever a COO before? Have you ever been? No. Prior to being the VP of growth, have you ever been that for a national company before? No. We went around the room. I said, have I ever been the CEO? No. So wait, none of us in this room are technically qualified to be in any positions via title. But how did we all get here, right? And it really is some of the things you're talking about from this book, is we're all clear on who we are and the skill sets that we have. And I don't need to have had 20 years experience to qualify for that. I mean, you didn't have 20 years of qualifying to buy these mergers.
Those who we look up to, leaders, people that are of influence, they grow into that title. But because they have that power within, they have that awareness about themselves, about their experience in life, their skill sets, their strengths, their weaknesses, and they know that with themselves. And then they know that begin with their teams, and to know their human needs. And we talk about that in the book, right? And so once we're aware of all of that, then that makes us this very potent person within an organization to then just fill in the gaps and to be able to have this go-to mentality that everybody knows, hey, you're going to go to Steven to solve this. Even if they're not the leader, people are going to go to them and say, hey, how do we solve this problem? And
so
then
true.
The byproduct of that is the actual title, is the actual role, the responsibility. And then that's where you can actually amplify your title position to then make more effective change in the organization and outside the organization.
Yeah. You can't deny presence.
Yeah.
You can't deny it. Doesn't matter.
Because we all know those people, right?
Yeah,
exactly. That are in an organization, and they're not the leader, but they're like, and maybe they're new, maybe they're in the middle, but everyone's like, boom, that's
the leader.
Person.
Yeah.
That's like they know the deal and they just make stuff happen. Well, that could be anybody as long as you're willing to put in the sweat equity and not talking about hustle and grind, but working on yourself, figuring out who you are, what your purpose is, how do you fit into the overall larger mission of the organization, and just crushing it.
Man, first of all, Lane, it was so nice to meet you and a pleasure to meet you. I've obviously, Steven, you and I have known each other for a little bit, and I was excited to have you both on. I'm a big fan of this topic and this book. Guys, I can't encourage you who's listening today, encourage you enough to go get this book. And again, don't just, there's certain books that we've had people on promote, and they're very good books, et cetera. But this message of what you're talking about to me is very, very important in the time that we're in. Again, obviously it's timeless. I think these things will go on for a long time, but it's very important right now in the landscape we're in. So you guys listening to this, go get this book, Unleash Your Humble Alpha. Time went super fast, but it was an honor to have both of you on the show today. We're gonna have to get some, here's what we'll do. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get some people to read this book, and I'm gonna get their success stories, and I'm gonna get those to you. I want you guys to hear that, because I know what effort goes into writing a book. And
it took a year. It took over a year to write this book.
Yeah, I mean, as you said, you're creating a movement. It's starting a movement with this, and so I want you guys to hear the results of that movement. So,
excellent.
Really appreciate that. Yeah.
Yeah, pleasure to have you both on the show today. Truly been blessed. Our audience has been blessed. Guys, every week on Connect, Share, Prosper, bringing people like Steven and Lane who share success stories and struggles and the things that they're working on to impact people's lives and communities around the country and around the world. We appreciate every one of you listening to this episode. Again, Monday, noon central, Master Network's Facebook page. I think we're almost into episode 150 of these weekly episodes. So make sure you join us every Monday, noon central. Again, Steven, Lane, thank you for being on this episode of Connect, Share, Prosper.
My pleasure.
Stop hoping for your business to grow and start mastering the formula for success that every entrepreneur needs to grow their business. Join us for 5 Plus 1 Mastery, where every week we go in depth on how to grow your business the right way. Learn more at 5plus1mastery.com.